Right, this class we shall discuss how to find the largest of a few numbers. Assume that these are the few numbers given, 23, 45, 11, 22, 33, totally 5 numbers are there. So I call this as n. N is an array which consists of 5 numbers. Each number I can access by n of 0, n of 1, n of 2, n of 3, n of 4. In order to find the largest number, what we shall do is, we shall take the first number as the biggest number. Therefore, I make 23 itself as the largest number. Totally, since 5 numbers are there, I make the count is equal to 5. And since the first number itself we have taken, remaining there are 4 numbers to compare. Therefore, I decrement this to 4. Now we compare whatever is in big and the second number. 23 and 45 are compared. 23 is smaller, 43 is bigger. Therefore, 45 cannot be subtracted from 23 unless we get a carry. Therefore, since 23 is smaller than 45, what I do is, this 45 we shall bring it to big. Okay. Now there are 3 more numbers to be compared. Excuse me. Now again, 45 and 11 I compare. 45 is bigger, 11 is smaller. Therefore, we do not swap. Therefore, 2 more numbers are to compare. Now 45 and 22 we compare. Therefore, 45 is bigger. Therefore, I reduce the count 1. Now 45 and 33 I compare. 45 is bigger, therefore I do not swap, therefore decrement the counter. All the 5 numbers we have compared, now the largest number is 45. So this logic we shall apply in implementing an assembly language. As usual, I take the notepad. Now we shall take a text editor and we shall begin. So this is the largest number using 8086. Okay, now the first directive model small, second directive stack 256 memory locations, then data I call n and define byte. A few numbers I will take, 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 numbers I have taken. Okay, now if I take 34 will be converted into decimal. Therefore, I make this as equal to 34H, 67H, 89H, 12H, 55, 90, CDH, 23 and 67 and 88. Now, since this number begins with an alphabet, I start with a 0. Okay, so n, how many numbers I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 numbers are there. Therefore, I make this one more variable. I call variable count define word equal to 10. If I put H, then it will assume that it is a 60 numbers. Therefore, I do not put H because there are 10 decimal numbers. Okay. Then I take one more variable, largest define byte and uninitialized. Okay. My data is over. The code begins. Now begin, move AX, comma, the starting address of data, move in data segment AX. I complete this one, move AH, comma, 4CH is the service number, enter 21H, this is for exit to the DAS, and begin. Alright. Now, as I said, we have to compare the first number, then second number, third number, and so on. Therefore, I will take an index register, that is like a index. So move SI comma 0. Okay, this is for getting this first number, second number, third number and all. Now since I want this number to be repeated 10 times, therefore in CX register I put the count. Therefore I initially higher, since I plan to load in CX, that is why I have initiated this as a defined word. Therefore, my CX register is equal to 10. All right. The first number itself, I will take it as the largest number. Therefore, I will use BL register because each number is a byte. Therefore, move BL, comma, and what is my number? N of SI. That is, SI is 0, N of 0 is 34. The first number itself, I call it as the largest number, which I keep it in BL. Okay. One number already we have taken. Therefore, there are 9 more numbers. Therefore, decrement CX. Now CX becomes 9. Then increment SI. I prepare for getting the second number. Now we shall compare whatever is in BL and whatever is in the N of SI. That is, BL already contains 34. And now I am comparing with 67. Now 34 and 67. From 34, 67 cannot be compared. Therefore, it will get a carry. If a carry is generated, that means the this number is smaller. Therefore, what shall we do is jump on no carry, then I use a label no swap. Otherwise, what I do is I bring that number in BL register, N of SI. Okay, now otherwise, if no swap is there, means now my job is over. Therefore, I loop means automatically it will decrement the CX and it will repeat as long as it is equal to 0. Therefore, I use one more label called as again, and therefore I use this one is equal to again. Therefore, it increments the SI, so it gets the third number, and the third number is compared with BL, and again if it is smaller, nothing is done. If it is bigger, it is brought. Okay, once of all the numbers are compared, now I bring that number in the variable largest BL. Okay, so this completes my logic. Let us check whether it works or not, because we are not sure whether it will work. Therefore, I save. I call this one is equal to big or biggest dot asm, all files. Let us go to the debug, tasm biggest. Okay, no errors are there. Then link biggest, then debug biggest dot exe, and u for unassemble, then g for go, and d for dump. Dump, what is the location here? 0b8b, therefore 0b8b colon 0. Now let us check what are the numbers I have. Sorry, this has enlarged. Now you can check it out. What are the numbers? 34. Yes, here you can compare this 34 and whatever is here. See that this number 34, then 67, 89, 12, 55, 90, then CD, then 23, 67. The next number was 88. And the A, this one 000A is my count. Count is equal to 10. Therefore, 000A. And the largest number is equal to, out of this from 34, the largest number is equal to CD. Therefore, I got the largest number is equal to CD. Alright, if you want to check with another number, what shall we do is, we shall quit this one. And I mean, instead of CD, I will make this one is equal to say 77. And again, I save it. And again, we shall repeat the process. TASM, link, debug, U for unassemble, then G for go, then D for dump, and 0B8B colon 0. And now you can see that 34, 67, 89, 12, 55, 90, 22, 23, 67, 88. And 000A is the count, and the largest number is equal to 90. Yes, you can see that the largest number out of the 10 numbers is 80, 90, therefore 90 is there. So this is how we can develop a program to find the largest of 10 numbers. Now it is quite obvious, we can find the smallest number simply by making, instead of jump on no carry, if we say that jump on carry, we will find the smallest number. Right, try this as a homework and